Good evening, this is my second time trying this, so let's see if this works this time. I'm doing session one video response, and I chose to answer, is it morally ethical to use social technology to influence others? And I chose a specific verse for this one. I chose Ephesians 4:29. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouth, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. When you're on social media, to me that means do not spread any rumors or anything that is going to be seen hurtful to others, a group of other people, or pretty much to anyone. Do not place that out there, because once you put that out there, you can't take it back. I think you can use social media to influence others, as long as it's done in a moral way. We moved here from Grand Junction, Colorado in April, and my children were born and raised there, so we still stay in touch with a lot of people over there. And there's a little girl over there named Delaney Clements, who is fighting leukemia. She is on her fifth time around. We have come back again. She just gave a very powerful talk on 365. If you guys have a chance to look it up, her name's Delaney Clements. If you look it up on Facebook, she's put as a public figure, and you can view the video that she did. It was a very powerful video. She spoke of faith. She spoke of dying. She spoke of when she knows that she may not make it, and when she dies, that she is looking forward to walking to the pearly gates and not being sick and feeling good and just going through there and just feeling great. And she's 13 years old. It's amazing. She is spreading a powerful message to empower others to find a cure for childhood cancer, especially leukemia. That is what she's fighting. She's using social media to help others because she knows she may not be around much longer, but she wants to help others who are fighting this deadly disease. She wants to let others know that childhood cancer is real and it affects real people every day, and she wants to put a face to that childhood cancer. So to me, that is using social media in one of the most powerful ways possible, trying to save others' lives and to educate people and to kind of give a video diary of what she's going through and to put a face to a child that is fighting this. So again, look that up. It's powerful. It's great. She's just an amazing child. But that, to me, when you watch that video, that is what you use social media for. I watch my children's Facebook accounts. I watch their Twitter. I watch their Snapchat. I watch anything that they post on blogs. I have their passwords, and I go in and ensure that they're doing the right thing when I'm not looking. And they know that I go on there, but still, kids are kids. They may think, oh, mom can never know what it is. But I do. I look at it every week. And I like to see who they're friends with and what their friends are posting. They know that I get on their friends' pages, and their friends know that, you know, Ashley's mom Facebook stalks us. But I want to see what they're saying. I want to see if the people that she associates with are posting things that are ethical. I tell my children that once you put something out there, you can't take it back. It's out there on the internet. It never just goes away. Even if you delete the post, it was there. Somebody could have shared it. Somebody could have screenshotted it. Somebody could have screenshotted it and Snapchatted it. Either way, it's there, and it's there forever. So I tell them, when you're on any kind of social media, it needs to be something that, would my mother approve of this? And I try to teach my children to live a very high morals and live very ethically. So they watch who they associate with, and they watch who they spend time with. But my youngest son, both my boys have a disability, and my youngest son also has Asperger's. So they know the whole bullying thing, and they tend to stand up for the underdog. So they don't tend to get caught up in the drama that is social media, where they're talking bad about each other and they're downplaying people's emotions, and they just don't get involved in that drama. I'm a big, in the mornings when I'm getting ready for work or when I'm cleaning house, I watch CNN. So my kids watch CNN because I do. And they've been watching a lot with the presidential nominees and just the ridiculousness that's going on right now. We watched something about one of them Snapchatting about what Carly Farina, can you pronounce your last name, wore to one of the debates. And my daughter was like, Mom, what does it matter what she was wearing if she's going to be president? What does it matter what she wears? If she wears jeans, does that mean she can't be president? Well, no, it's just them trying to make somebody look bad and using social media because they're, again, they know once it's out there's going to be millions of people that see that. They're using social media in a negative way. They're using it to try to boost their numbers. But hopefully most people will see right through that and see that what does it matter what somebody's wearing, what they look like, what their hair looks like, what the color of their tie is, what their wife was wearing to the debate, what their husband was wearing to the debate. Who cares? I care about what matters to society as a whole, what they're going to do for our economy, what they're going to do for infrastructure, what they're going to do for climate, for the climate problems that we're having, what they're going to do to feed people, what they're going to do to instill a higher sense of morals and standards within our country. I don't care what they ate for breakfast. But there again, they're using Facebook and they're using Twitter to spread messages that don't, they're really not even messages, they're just bad rumors to boost their numbers, and they're not using it in a moral and ethical way. I find that to be very absurd. Where we came from in Grand Junction, there was a lot of Facebook groups that were like Helping Hands or Helping Angels or Moms Helping Moms. And we always chose a family every year to adopt at Christmas time. So when we moved over here, about a month ago, me and my daughter started looking for Facebook groups over here to, you know, see who we could adopt as a family over here because it's just kind of a tradition. So I found a nice Facebook group and I put it out there that we would look to adopt a family. I had a bunch of suggestions, and me and the kids picked a family the other day, and we'll supply presents. You know, so the parents can wrap them in, say they're from grandma, and say they're from them, and say they're from Santa. And we give them a gift card so they can go to the grocery store and purchase a nice, all the ingredients they need for a nice Christmas meal. And then we get something for the parents so they can go out on a dinner date, like a gift card to a local restaurant. And we always get the parents something small as well. So they have something to open up that morning as well from Santa. But I do that, number one, because I think that you should always give back to those less fortunate. You never know. I mean, you never know when you're going to be in that position. And if you have the means to do so, I believe that you should. And I believe that you should help those who are struggling. But we do it through Facebook. And to me, that shows, I show my kids, you know, this is what you use social media for. You use it to connect with people. You use it to help others. You use it to spread a powerful message. I've met many of my mom's siblings on Facebook. I've been connected with a lot of family members. That is a positive. You use Facebook if you're wanting to raise money for, say, leukemia. You can spread your message through Facebook, through Twitter, through Snapchat, any kind of social media, and it's going to reach thousands of people, and just that one right person might see that and be able to help more than what you would be able to help, or be able to spread it to their friends, or they have a friend that's a researcher, or whatever it may be, but you're using social networking, you're using social media to spread something positive. You don't use it to spread something negative. So I believe that you can totally use any kind of social networking, social media website to spread a message or to influence others in a positive way, as long as it is in a positive way. But talking about others and downgrading people is not positive. That's not what we should be using social media for. We should be using it for awareness. We should be using it for uplifting people. We should be using it for people to have funny moments. To get up and look and see something on your Facebook page in the morning to make you laugh and start your day right. That's what we should be using social media for. Thank you, and you guys have a great night.